It is ironical that in the West today, many countries are adopting secularism and disowning their Christian roots. And yet at the same time, today in the West, there are many movements for change, movements for freedom of speech, dignity of women, and so many other issues the world is championing. And yet, very sadly, these movements have become more ideological than rooted in real foundation. Because very often, all these movements that are in process today, they fail to realize that they are deeply rooted in the Christian gospel. Without the Christian gospel, without Christ, there is no foundation for all those things that are championing in the world today. This is why Christianity is not an ideology. Christianity, so to speak, is not even a revolutionary movement. The church does not intend to be another revolutionary movement in the world, because Christian faith is not based on some philosophy, some kind of ideology. It is based on our faith in Jesus. Jesus is the foundation of all that we do. Because of relationship in Christ, we are transformed. In every level of relationship, not just with our fellow men, but even with the whole of creation. So Christianity does transform the world, but not as a movement, but more because anyone who comes to be in touch with the Lord Jesus, he will be transformed in mind and heart. Christ reveals to us that he is the image of God. All of us are one in Christ. In Christ, we have become brothers and sisters. Jesus is identified with every human person. This is the basis for us to speak about the dignity of every human person, because we are created in God's image and likeness. This is the same foundation that we as Christians condemns the culture of death, whether abortion, euthanasia, because of our deep respect for every human person who is created in the image and likeness of God. Every human person is our brother and sister in Christ, because we are the body of Christ. And it is for this reason we promote respect. No discrimination of anyone. That is why Christianity changes the way we see people and every relationship. We can be a superior over somebody. Yet all of us, we work for the same Lord. All of us work for God. There is only one master. That is God. All of us in different positions, whether you are master, whether you are boss, whether you are subordinate, we all work for the glory of God, for the betterment of humanity. It doesn't matter whether you are boss or whether you are worker. You have to treat everyone with the same respect. It doesn't mean because he's the boss, you treat him better. This person is a domestic helper, you just treat her or treat him without respect. Everybody is equal in the eyes of God, but different in responsibility, so that together we serve God. That is the kind of attitude we should have in the way we regard others. Why the church does not endorse social discrimination, gender discrimination, on the same basis? Because we are all children of God. Whether men or women, whether husband or wife, all of us are one in Christ. We are called to complement one another. There should be no discrimination of any sort, because all of us, we work for the same God. And it is Christianity, actually, that removes all this discrimination in society because of the emphasis on the dignity of the human person. But my dear brothers and sisters, have you wondered? Today the world is promoting, for example, removal of death penalty. But they're not consistent. They promote abortion, they promote euthanasia. What is the basis for removing death penalty? What is the basis for human rights? If you don't believe in God, you don't believe that man is unique in the whole of creation, if you don't believe that man has a soul, are we much different from other animals? So it is very important, once again, to remind ourselves, all that the world is championing today, without faith in Christ, without faith in the gospel, there is no basis. It becomes simply an ideology. One who just promotes something because he has a passion for it. But for us, it is really motivated by our love for Christ and therefore love for our brothers and sisters.